We're going to show how we calculate work for both reversible and irreversible processes where we have expansion and compression in a piston cylinder. So first we'll look at expansion and we'll look at a reversible process. And so work in general for both types of processes, work is minus the integral of the external pressure times the differential volume change. Because we're talking about a reversible process, the external pressure is identical to pressure inside the piston, the pressure of the gas. And so this becomes the integral of the pressure times the change in volume, where now we're talking about pressure of the gas. That means the work is the area under the curve shown here crosshatched. This is reversible work. The area is proportional to the reversible work as we expand from point one to point two. And the piston then moves from left to right. So now let's look in contrast to an irreversible process. So I'm showing a specific irreversible process, and there's essentially an infinite number. But here we're going to expand where the final pressure is pressure 2. Again, work is equal to P external dV. I'm making the external pressure the final pressure, so pre-external delta V. And this area now, this is the irreversible work. So first notice the irreversible work is smaller. So this is work irreversible. The work is smaller. We have less resisting force. This, of course, is only one of many ways we could carry out an irreversible process. We could do it in steps, where we might first go to half the pressure and get an area, for example, like this, and then get a second area here for the other half. Or we could have no resistance, get no work out when we do an irreversible expansion. But when we're doing expansion, the irreversible work is going to be less than the reversible work. And these two processes are for any pathway. It doesn't have to be adiabatic or isothermal. It can be something in between, for example. So this expansion, let's look at the case now for compression. So of course, for compression, we're going to start at the low pressure, point one, and go to the higher pressure. Again, work is for a reversible process, integral of the pressure to gas, dV, with a minus sign. And so this, again, reversible work, looks identical, but the sign is going to be opposite for the numerical value. We're putting work into the system to compress it as the gas moves from a larger volume to the smaller volume. In contrast, if we look at the irreversible process, so for the irreversible process, again, you're going to have to use the external pressure. In this case, we're looking at a case where we have the final pressure. We have to at least have the final pressure to compress to that value. We don't have to have it the entire time, but we certainly have to have it at the end. And we're going to do this irreversibly. So again, it's P external dV. And we're looking at a case where it's a constant external pressure, pressure P2. Notice this area is the irreversible work, and it's much larger than the reversible work, right? So the work irreversible, we have to put more work in to compress the irreversibly because now we're using the same large pressure during the entire compression. And so the pressure external is higher than the gas pressure until we get to the final point two. For compression, the work we have to put in numerical value is larger. For expansion, the work we get out numerical value is smaller for irreversible process.